Amen. Listen, it is another day of 21 days of simply devotion and prayer. This is us. This is our reality. It's the Carters. And we thank you for being a part tonight of the 9th Street Missionary Baptist Church, 21 days of prayer with Stephanie, Chloe, and myself. Yeah, she's our special guest tonight. She just can't get right. She can't sit still, but we gonna try our best to do what we do with Chloe in the mix. Listen, I wanna tell everybody, it is not by choice, but it is by design that you're here tonight. In this devotional, the Lord has placed it upon my heart to give to you substance by way of devotion and prayer. This is to make sure and to build our faith, to build our spiritual relationship with Christ and make it that much stronger day by day. It is said that 21 days of doing something, 21 days consistently, becomes now a habit. And our prayer tonight is that after we finish the 21 days of devotion is that you will keep pace, keep on target of the 21 days of your own personal devotion and prayer in your prayer life. We pray that you get stronger in your word, but also just your overall spiritual relationship. I simply want to tell you the purpose of devotionals tonight is to take a step away from daily routine and focus on spiritual matters for a while. I'm gonna say this to you again. The purpose of devotionals is to take a step away from the daily routine and focus on spiritual matters for a while. Y'all, we got to step away from what we're accustomed to doing on a day-to-day basis and focus on our spiritual matters. Amen.
Amen.
Allow now Sister Carter to give us our devotional for tonight. And once again, don't pay attention to Chloe. Try your best to pay attention to Sister Carter. Amen.
Amen. Okay, tonight's devotional says, at this Christmas season, let us give the gift of love, the gift of service to those around us, and the true gift of forgiveness. For as we repent, the Holy One of Israel forgives us. I testify that He lives. He is the King of Kings. He is the Prince of Peace. He is our Savior. He is our Redeemer. And He is our friend. If you guys recall, on yesterday, our journal talked about the season of giving. And we know the saying always says it's better to give than receive. But tonight's devotional really expounds on what those gifts could be. We often think of the tangible gifts, the things that can often be forgotten later on, or either the sentimental value, we forget about it. Some of those items, as Chloe can explain, end up being broken. But the gifts of this season should be eternal gifts, gifts that we can carry with us for a lifetime. And it says tonight, the gift of forgiveness, the gift of love. We want to give the gift of compassion, of kindness, of gentleness in this season.
Amen. And that's what it's all about. It's about giving. So many times we focus on giving the wrong things, but in this season, I think it is certainly our Christian duty to give spiritual advice to individuals who simply seek out a better relationship with Christ. And so many times we focus on the gift, but not the giver, which Amen. Is Christ. Mm-hmm. Amen. Because we know what Christ did for all of us. And so on this day, we prepare you now to begin putting all of your comments, all of your prayer requests right now into the comment section. We would love for you to go ahead and make those prayer requests known unto God and to all of the prayer warriors who are on this phone line, on our conference line tonight, and who are on this social media network. Allow us now, and I'm looking at your comments. I'm looking right now at all of your desires, your requests. The Bible says to make your request known unto God. Amen. And that's what I'm asking of you on tonight, is to make those prayer requests known unto God, but then to all the other prayer warriors who are on this phone line and on this Facebook Live feed on tonight. Allow us now this opportunity to go to God in prayer. Most gracious God, our Father, Lord, how we thank you.
Thank you, God.
For another day, another hour of prayer, another hour of devotion. And Father, here it is again. Just a few of your humble servants, God, coming together as one body of believers. God, we come before you as filthy rags, knowing that you are our full fountain.
Yes, Lord.
God, we come before you tonight, knowing that you are our company keeper, God.
Yes, God.
God, we come to you tonight, knowing that you are the purposeful one. You are the reason why we have our being. You are the reason why we have life and life more abundantly. And tonight, God, we come sincerely to your throne of grace. Now, God, we know that your grace is sufficient.
Yes, God.
And God, we know that your mercies are new every morning.
Every morning.
Now, Father, we are asking now is that you would come into this on this prayer line, on this Facebook Live feed, God, and have thine own way.
Have your way, Lord.
God, we're asking now is that you begin now saturating our atmosphere, God, and allowing us to focus, God, on who you are, being our giver, being our way maker, God, being our shaper, God, being our guide, God. We come tonight, God, asking for strength and power and wisdom and God, anointing tonight, God. God, we are asking tonight is that you would allow your love for us, God. We are asking now is that we share your love,
yes,
that you have for us, God.
Thank
God,
you.
We thank you for the love that you have showed us by way of your son, Jesus Christ. God, we thank you tonight, God, for even allowing him to die at Calvary's cross, God, but then to rise up with all power in the very palms of his hand. Now, Father, tonight, God, we are asking a special blessing, God, a special blessing, God, to everyone that is on this feed tonight, God. I begin now, God, not calling any names, but God, those individuals that you see, that you know, that are present, God, I'm asking now is that you would start, God, removing everything that seems to be a distraction. God, they have been praying, God, diligently about the things that are causing them to be farther away from you. And on tonight, God, you know what they stand in need of. You know what's blocking their pathway to you, God. You know what's stopping them, God, from having that great relationship, God, the great relationship that you require of all of us. Now, Father, I'm asking now if it's a job, I'm asking, God, is that you would fix it so they are not distracted by a job.
Right now.
God, if it's a spousal issue, God, I am asking now, God, is that you would simply take care of that. If it's a friend, God. God, I'm asking now that you would take care of that distraction, God. Whoever is distracting us, if it's a thing, God, I'm asking tonight is that you would simply remove it in the mighty name of Jesus. God, in this season, we are calling upon you, God. We are calling upon your holy and righteous name, God. God, we are thankful tonight. We are grateful tonight to call you our daddy. We are grateful tonight to call you our Father God. We thank you for looking down low, God, looking up high and looking down low upon us. We thank you for your covering tonight, God. God, we thank you for your manifestation tonight. God, we just ask that you will continuously to open your arms wide for us, God. God, continuously to hold us, continuously to mold us, God, continuously to guide us and to be the Christians, to be the saints that you want us to be. Now, God, there is somebody tonight that is literally facing all types of issues, God. There is so many people, God, on the line tonight, God, who are seeking a better relationship with thee. And God, I'm asking tonight is that you would simply begin anointing their mind, right, anointing now, their heart, right, anointing now, their ears, anointing their eyes, God. God, fix whatever needs to be fixed with these old feeble bodies of ours, God. I'm asking now, God, is that you would just continuously to pour in us, God, the love that we're missing. Continuously to pour in us the peace that we're missing, God. God, we're asking tonight, God, is that you would simply bless all of our families. God, bless our families, beginning with the father. God, bless our families, God, beginning with the mothers. Bless our families, beginning with the children. Bless our families, beginning with the daughters, God. God, there is so much that is going on in our world today, God. God, people are at odds. People are at their wits' end with one another. And on tonight, God, we are asking now is that you begin bringing the families back, starting with our households, God. God, bringing the Christian households back together again. God, you have made us a separated people. And God, on tonight, God, we are simply wanting to show. We are wanting to show the world who we are. God, that number one, we are not ashamed of who we are, God. You told us in your word, if we be ashamed to own you, that you will be ashamed to own us before your Father, which is in heaven. God, we are claiming tonight, God, that we are gaining our families back. God, we are gaining our friends back. God, we are gaining our anointing back. We are gaining now, God, our spirituality back tonight, God. God, we just believe in John 3:16, where it says, for God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten son. God, I am thankful tonight that you loved us so much, that you cared about us so much, that you decided to give up your only, God. And God, on tonight, God, I am asking, God, I am asking now is that you would remove Satan, God. God, I'm asking that you would remove our adversary. I'm asking now that you would remove Lucifer, God. I'm asking that you would bind him out of all of our lives, God. God, would you sanctify us tonight, God? Please sanctify us in the mighty name of Jesus. Allow us to be used for your glory, God. Not so that we get the glory, but for your glory on tonight. God, somebody tonight wants to be able to stand up, God, and announce who you are, God. But somebody's been afraid, God. Somebody's been afraid to say that you are their father. Somebody's been afraid to say that you are their daddy. Somebody's been afraid to say that you've been the one that's been looking out. It hasn't been us, God, but it's been you, God, the only wise and true God. Tonight, God, we are proclaiming tonight that we are going forth in Jesus' name. God, bring back restoration. Bring back renewing, God. God, we are asking that you would just manifest, God, manifest your ability for this world, God, for the sins of this world. God, we know that you are the maker. We know that you are the creator. We know that you are the ruler. God, we ask tonight, God, is that you would just take your rightful place in all of our lives. Take your rightful place in this land and country. Take your rightful place, God. Take your rightful place in our lives. Now, Father, we're asking tonight that you be a healer. God, we're asking that you be a healer tonight, God. We're asking that you walk into every nursing home. We're asking that you walk into every hospital. God, we're asking now that you walk into every house. And God, you know what type of healing needs to take place, God. And God, I just see it right now. I see right now, I see your hand of mercy, God. I see your hand of goodness, God. I see your hand of peace, God. I see your hand of salvation, God, walking all around the houses, God, walking all around our rooms. I see you right now, God, being a deliverer, God. Somebody is strung out tonight, God, and not only strung out on drugs, but strung out on relationship matters. And I'm asking tonight, God, that you deliver sanctification tonight. God, teach us how to love ourselves. But before we can love ourselves, we got to learn how to love you. God, we cast our cares on you tonight, God. Deliver us from this world of sin, God. This world of shame, God. This world of disobedience, God. I'm asking tonight, God, is that you would sanctify us. God, bring us back, God. God, bring us back to the fold, God. Yes. Those who have strayed away, God. Yes. Those who have gotten away from your word. Yeah. I'm asking now that you would bring them back, God.
Bring them back,
God, I am asking now is that you would touch every right individual now. Who has walked away from you, God, who has denounced you, God. I am asking now, Father, is that you would bring a sense of security, that you would bring a sense of safetyness back to your people, God. God, please on tonight, God, hear our cry, hear our call tonight, God. Hold our hand, God. God, guide our footstep, God. God, we're asking tonight is that you would simply order all of our steps, God. Order our steps in your word, God. God, order our tongue in your word, God.
Yes,
God,
Lord.
Order our lips in your word, God. Order our eyes in your word, God. Order our minds and our brains in your word, God. God, we're trusting you, God, to bring us through, God. We're trusting in you, God, to see us safely through every situation. Now, God, you know what our government stands in need of tonight. God, you know what our government stands in need of tonight. God, we thank you now for the new man that you placed in office, God. God, we thank you for Joe Biden and Kamala Harris, God. We thank you for these individuals, God. God, prove the people wrong. Let them know, God, that you're still yet in charge. God, bring a sense of peace into the White House again. God, bring reassurance to the White House again. God, I ask on tonight, God, even our state and local governments, God. God, go with the mayors. Go with the governors. God, we ask tonight is that you would protect them right where they are. God, give them a sound mind to make a sound decision on behalf of your people. Now, Father, even our troops that are on foreign soil tonight, God, protect every troop. Protect their families that they've left behind. Tonight, God, we are asking now is that we become more obedient in this season, God. Give us the gift of being obedient, God. God, give us the gift of hearing your voice clearly, God. God, we proclaim tonight that victory is in your name, God. Victory is in your word, God. Victory is right in our very room tonight, God. We pray tonight, God, is that if you would just allow us one more sunny day, God, we gonna praise you like none other, God. God, on tonight, as we prepare to lay our heads on a soft pillow, I ask now that you will protect every individual under the sound of my voice. God, give them a sense of peace as they lay down tonight.
Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord.
Thank it's you, in God. Jesus' name.
Thank you, Jesus.
It's in Jesus' name that all of God's people say it together. Amen. And thank God.
Thank you, God. Amen.
Tonight, we close out telling you that God is able to do anything but fail. God can. God will. And God wants to make changes in all of our lives. It is in thee, O Lord, we put all of our trust, and our trust is only in Christ Jesus. May you rest well tonight, sweet children, knowing that God has you covered, yet while you lay down, you go and tell the Lord thank you as you leave. Tomorrow, we'll see you in the same place with a different devotionary story and with a different prayer to reach the heavens above. God bless you.